chein, this incredible Hebrew word, indeed a blessing from Hashem, that a person should have chein, as it says in Mishlei, umetza chein v'seichel tov be'einei Elokim v'adam, as we allude to in benching, we should find chein in the eyes of Hashem and in people's eyes. What is chein? Such a difficult word to translate. And indeed, it's one of the beautiful blessings, the blessings of the Birkat Kohanim that we read in Parashat Naso, and it's a unique halakha. Birkat Kohanim is the only bracha that has to be said in Hebrew. That if you say it in any other language, you have not fulfilled your obligation, even b'diavad, even post facto, only in Hebrew. It's the blessings of the Hebrew words that emanate from the mouths of the Kohanim that is so unique to this blessing. And what is one of the brachot we know? Yivarechcha Hashem v'yishmarecha, that Hashem should bless us and guard us. Ya'er Hashem panav elecha v'chonek, and Hashem should cause His light to shine upon us. And how should that light express itself? In chein, vichuneka, He should give you chein. People should see you with chein. Such a difficult word to translate. Perhaps grace, to find favor in people's eyes. And there's a beautiful explanation of what chein means in Or HaChaim HaKadosh. We know that it's twice mentioned in the book of Bereshit. Once somebody finds favor in God's eyes, v'noach matza chein b'enei Hashem. Noach finds favor in God's eyes, and also Yosef finds favor in the eyes of the Sar, Beit HaSar, the one responsible for the prison. And the Or HaChaim HaKadosh got a beautiful page on what it means to find chein in people's eyes. And as he reads, it says, Vayihi Hashem et Yosef. Hashem was with Yosef in prison. And therefore the source of all chein is from Hashem. It's a blessing from God. And it says, Vayetz Elav Chased, Hashem gave him kindness, Vayitain Chino b'nei Sar Beit HaSar. And Hashem gave him chein. What is this chein that somehow melted hearts and won over antagonists to Yosef? And he says beautifully, Ki lo targish b'chinat hara b'metek achein. He says it's a gift from Hashem, that Hashem somehow allows people only to see your inner beauty, to see you with grace, to see you with favor, and to ignore whatever negatives and alternative parts, the ra in every person's personality that there is. Wherever Yosef went, people would see him with chein and favor, only see the good in him. And that's indeed what we're asking Hashem for in this blessing, the Birkat Kohanim. We're saying to Hashem, may it be that we find favor in all people's eyes. When people see us, they encounter us, let them overlook whatever shortcomings and whatever bad, and only see the beauty, the good, the inner beauty, the favor, and the chesed. That is what we so deeply hope for and pray for in the Birkat HaKohanim, the blessings of the Kohen. These last 2 weeks, we have seen incredible grace, chein from Hashem, finding chein and grace in the eyes of the nations of the world. The world superpower, the United States, moving the embassy to Jerusalem, followed by Guatemala, and this last week by Paraguay. Truly, moves of historic proportions, acknowledging what is so obvious to so many other countries and their capital cities, acknowledging it this week. Indeed, we have found favor in Hashem's eyes and in the eyes of nations. But at the same time, there's so much more favor still to find and to pray for and to listen in Birkat Kohanim. How many other nations we have not found favor, which highlight how this somehow ludicrously is equitable. So-called peaceful demonstrations in the border, Gaza border, and Israel aggression, as opposed to violent rioting at a border of a country, trying to break the border, acknowledged to kill people, to hijack soldiers, and to kill soldiers and civilians. In a way which is a closed military zone, and that can't be seen with grace, how it should so obviously be seen, but rather to focus on the negative, the killing which needed to happen in order to defend Israel's borders, which any country would do, and so much more than that, under such aggression by an internationally recognized terror organization, clearly declaring what it is trying to do. There's so much favor still to find. And maybe as we read Birkat Kohanim in Parashat Naso, may we elicit the favor of Hashem in the eyes of Hashem and in the eyes of all the nations of the world. First and foremost in our own personal lives, to find favor in the eyes of those around us, that we should see favor in the eyes of others, to judge them favorably, to judge them with grace, to, as the Or HaChaim said, to ignore the ra, the inevitable less than perfect parts of all of our personalities, to ignore those and to focus on the grace and the kindness and the qualities of good in everyone. And so too, the Jewish people as a klal, may we continue to find favor in the eyes of Hashem and the nations as we have this week, but to further that grace and to deepen it in every possible way. Shabbat Shalom.